Imagination Studio presents Telling Christina Goodbye by Lurlene McDaniel. Read for you by Ashley Albert. One. During the first week of classes after Christmas break at Mooresville High School, Trisha went looking for Christina. She found her best friend crying in the girls' bathroom. It didn't take a rocket scientist to figure out why. Tucker Hansen. Trisha slipped into the stall where Christina was hiding. Christina wiped her eyes.
Well, where are the others? I don't want them to see me like this.
Cody's waiting outside in the hall.
Why couldn't I get a guy like Cody?
You mean instead of Tucker? Tucker is the reason you're crying, isn't he? Christina nodded.
I ran into Bill Lawler at the library last night. Tucker was supposed to pick me up, but we'd had a fight and he didn't show. Bill offered to drive me home, and on the way we stopped for coffee. Someone must have told Tucker, because when he picked me up for school this morning, he was really upset. I tried to explain that there's nothing between me and Bill, but he won't believe me.
So now he's mad because you had coffee with Bill? What's wrong with that?
I shouldn't have gone out with another guy.
Oh, please, you had coffee together. How can he be that insecure? You've been with him since the eighth grade.
Are you saying Cody wouldn't object if you were seen having coffee with some other guy?
Christina sounded defensive. Frank Russo and I go out all the time, and Cody doesn't feel threatened.
You're co-editors of the yearbook. Of course you go out. Plus, Frank has Abby for a girlfriend.
The point is, Cody trusts me. Tucker should trust you, too.
That's what I told him, but he's still angry.
Then that's his problem. He needs to get over it.
There are other things. I have been accepted at the University of Vermont.
That's wonderful, Trisha interrupted. Christina smiled for the first time.
Mom and Dad think so too, especially since it came with a scholarship. But Tucker hates the idea. He can't accept that I would go so far from Indiana, or him. He wants me to go someplace in-state.
How can Tucker expect you to change your future for him? Why doesn't he change his plans? Trisha asked.
He has to start at the community college because his grades are poor. I know you and Cody are planning to go to IU together, so don't pretend you're making any sacrifice.
We do plan on going to IU, but first we have to be accepted. I'm telling you, if I had a valid scholarship offer, I'd take it. Tucker should be happy for you.
Christina raked a comb through her hair. You're the one I'm going to miss the most if I go away to Vermont.
Trisha put her hand on Christina's arm before they stepped into the hall. Don't let Tucker make you do something you don't want to do.
Tuck's not so bad, Cody said after school.
Trisha told him about her conversation with Christina. He tries to control her and she won't stand up to him, Trisha grumbled. I think that's pretty bad. The way he blows up if she goes against his wishes, telling her where to go to college or who she can have coffee with.
So he's a little jealous. We guys get that way when someone makes a move on our girl.
A move? We're talking Billy Lawler here. The guy's no more a threat to Tucker than I am to Miss America.
Cody put his arm around Trisha's shoulders.
You're right. Tuck has no reason to worry, but it's just his way.
Don't defend him.
They walked out into the snow-covered parking lot.
Cody jammed his hand into her coat pocket and pulled her closer.
They've been acting that way for years. I can't see it changing.
But why? Christina's smart. Why does she let him treat her like she's stupid?
They love each other, just like I love you.
A horn honked two rows over, and a male voice shouted,
I said, get in the car right now!
Startled, Trisha and Cody looked over to see Tucker driving beside a walking Christina, who was ignoring him.
You want a ride, Chrissy? Trisha yelled.
I'm taking her home, Tucker said. We have to talk, don't we, honey?
Don't get in the car, Trisha said under her breath. thanks,
Christina said after an agonizing minute.
But I'll go with Tucker. It's all right. I'll call you just as soon as I get home,
she called out. Christina hadn't even gotten the door shut before Tucker sped out of the parking lot. Cody slipped his arm around Trisha.
I'll talk to him, okay? He's not really a bad guy. He's scared of losing her. If she goes away, he's afraid she won't come back.
I hope she doesn't, Trisha said. I hope she leaves him flat.
2. Trisha banged into her house when her mother intercepted her. I need you to do me a favor. Charlie has to be at basketball practice and you have to take him.
Oh, Mom.
No buts. Do it. Just then, 12-year-old Charlie came from the kitchen, bouncing his basketball and eating an apple. Kill the ball, their mother said. Charlie grabbed the ball in mid-dribble.
She taken me? She drives like an old lady.
So hitchhike, Trisha snapped. Stop arguing, their mother said. Just go. Trisha marched out the front door, trailing Charlie and grumbling. The gym smelled like sweaty socks. She sat in the bleachers trying to concentrate on an assignment.
How are you doing?
Startled, Trisha looked up and saw Tucker.
Can I join you?
She had forgotten that his brother played on the same team as Charlie.
It's a free country, she told him.
She fidgeted because she didn't have much to say to Tucker.
How's Chrissy? She finally asked.
Mad at me?
Go figure.
Tucker smiled sheepishly.
So I lost my cool today.
Trisha didn't say anything.
You don't like me, do you?
Maybe I just don't like the way you treat Chrissy.
I really love her, you know. Tell her that for me.
Why should I?
Because she listens to you.
Not really.
Trisha knew that if Christina really listened to her, she'd dump Tucker.
Would you also tell her not to go off to Vermont?
He sounded solicitous, as if he really wanted the favor.
It's a great opportunity, Tucker. The scholarship is awesome.
If she stays, we can be together,
he said, as if she hadn't spoken.
I don't want her to go.
It's a long time until September. She deserves her chance. Maybe you'll change your mind.
No, she's all I ever wanted.
Then treat her like it, she suggested. Telling her how to act and who she can see isn't winning her over.
For a moment, a dark glower crossed his face.
I'm the best thing that ever happened to Chrissy. She'll never find a guy who cares about her the way I do.
He started down the bleachers toward the floor, clattering all the way. On Saturday, Christina talked Trisha into going with her to the nursing home where she was a volunteer. Trisha wasn't crazy about the place. Some of the elderly people looked so frail that it broke her heart. But Christina always said,
it makes me feel like I'm doing something useful.
As they walked inside, Trisha stepped around an old lady in a wheelchair. The woman was asleep, tied to the chair so that she wouldn't fall out. Trisha and Christina checked in at the nurse's station.
You're a sight for sore eyes, said Mrs. Kimball, the head floor nurse.
You remember my friend Trisha? She's helping out today.
Mrs. Kimball's smile lit her coffee-colored face.
Nice of you to lend a hand.
She picked up a chart.
Chrissy, can you feed Mr. Tappan in room 6?
Mrs. Kimball looked at Trisha.
Can I get you to take the patients on this list down to the exercise room? They're all in wheelchairs.
Trisha gathered the 8 patients and wheeled them into the exercise room where an aerobics instructor led them. It was after 5 when she went looking for Christina.
She's with Mr. Tappan, Mrs. Kimball said. Honestly, that old man won't do anything for anybody except her.
She shook her head. Trisha went to Mr. Tappan's room and stopped at the doorway. Christina was on her knees in front of the old man's wheelchair, feeding him spoonfuls of mashed potatoes. Trisha heard Christina saying,
Now open up. If you finish all your supper, I'll read you a story.
The old man stared straight ahead but opened his mouth. Although he closed his lips over the spoon, the potatoes dribbled down his chin.
Christina dabbed his chin with a napkin and offered another spoonful. Trisha watched, mesmerized. Christina never ran out of patience, and the old man opened his mouth obediently whenever she asked. Mrs. Kimball was right. Christina had a gift for working with the old man. After they left the nursing home, the girls stopped for burgers. I don't know how you do it.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.